Hi everyone, welcome to the last video of Introduction to Computer. So in this video, we are going to talk about the second component of the computer, the software. And then we will do a quick recap of what we have learned in this module. Okay, so let's get started. Software. First of all, what is a software and how it is different than the other component of the computer, which is the hardware. In the previous video, we stated that the hardware is the physical components of the computer, right? What about the software then? What is the software? Well, software, it is a collection of data. Okay? It's a collection of data, programs, and the instructions that can tell the electronic device how to work, how to run, and how to execute specific tasks. The software, it is written in the code that the computer can understand. So this computer, it only understands the bytecodes, okay, which you will learn it in the near future. The bytecodes are in the binary system. And the software, they are written in the program that can be translated into the bytecode so that the computer can understand at the end. And software, it enables to perform various functions and the tasks according to the user requirements. That's what software is. Okay. And you should also be familiar with the types of the software. The types of the software, it is divided into three main categories. One is the system software. The second one is the application software. And lastly, it is the programming software. Let's take a look at each of those different types of softwares and what they are for. First of all, the system software. Okay. So the system software, basically it refers to the collection of programs. Drivers, and utilities that enables the operations and the maintenance of the computer system. Okay. And it is designed to manage and to control the computer hardware. The system software is the one that manages and controls the computer hardware. And it provides a platform for running the application software. Okay. System software, it provides the platform for the application software, to run the application softwares. It also ensures the overall operations and management of the computer system. Okay. Some of the common examples of system software, it includes the operating system. Okay. And also the, as you can see here, the device drivers, firmware, utility softwares, okay, programming language translators, the IDEs, and many more. But out of those, you should be familiar with the operating systems, what is operating systems, and what is utility softwares, because they are the ones that you will see and interact more often. Okay. So in this system software, let's take a look at what does this operating system means in this system software. Okay. So operating system, it is a type of system software that basically manages the computer's hardware and software resources. Okay. It's the one that manages the resources of both hardware and software. It provides the common services for computer programs. And it also facilitates the execution of application softwares. It is designed to facilitate the execution of all the application softwares that we have in our computer. Okay, the examples of the most popular operating systems includes the Windows operating system, okay, Mac operating system, the ones that you have seen a lot. And besides the Windows operating system and Mac operating system, we also have the Linux operating system. And for the mobile devices, we also have Android and iOS, those operating systems. Okay. So this Windows, basically, it's developed by the Microsoft. This operating system is mainly designed for the desktop and laptops. Similar with the Mac operating system. Mac operating system, it's developed by the Apple. It's also designed for desktop and laptops. Okay. And the Linux, in the other hand, the third operating system that is the competitors of Windows and Mac. This Linux, it's basically an open source operating system. Okay. It is used on a wide range of devices, from smartphones to the servers. Okay. There are lots of Linux-based servers out there. And when it comes to mobile testing, mobile operating systems, we do have Android and iOS. Okay. Android is the operating system that is based on the Linux, actually. It is developed by the Google. And the iOS, it is developed by the Apple, this operating system. It is used on the iPhones, iPads, etc. Okay. So those operating systems, they provide the user interface to interact with the computers and manage the files, folders, run the application, and perform various different tasks. Okay. So those are what operating systems of system software. And the next type of system software that you should be familiar with is the utility software. Okay, you need to know what utility software is. So the utility software, it is a type of system software that provides essential tools and utilities to manage, optimize, and maintain the computer system. Okay, you use the utility software to maintain and optimize and manage the computer system that you have. So these tools, basically, they help us to help us to perform the various tasks such as disk cleanup, you know, also the system maintenance, okay, and data backup, antiviruses, virus scanning, and plenty more. So those are utility software to ensure that our computer system is functioning properly, okay. And yes, those are the most popular utility software. We have this Zip and then McAfee, all those antivirus systems, okay, and many more. Each type of application software is designed to basically, each type of those utility software is designed for specific purposes, okay, in order, and they will provide basically. Those utility system is an important component of the computer system, basically, okay? Because it helps the operating system to keep the system running, keep it running efficiently and smoothly. That's the main use case of the utility software. Right. So those are the system softwares that you need to know. And besides the system software, the another type of software that we have is application software. Okay, this is the one that you all have seen. It is a type of software that is designed to perform specific tasks or functions for the user. Each application software, it performs a specific task. Okay, and the application softwares, they can either be pre-installed on the computer or installed later on by the user. There are many different types of application softwares for different types of tasks, okay, including word processor, like Word documents, you know, and also like Excel, you know. Also, there are also application softwares for media players, for web browsers, right, and for gaming and many more, okay. Each type of those application software is designed it to serve a specific purpose or function for the user. For example, what do you use those browser applications for? Like Chrome, for example. Chrome is also an application software. What do we use it for? To navigate to specific URL, to visit the websites, right? And what do you use this PowerPoint or Windows operating system or this Word document, Excel sheets? So to type, edit the text, etc. Right. So each of those applications software, they have their own purposes. They serve different purpose. And then next, last type of software that we have is the programming software, the third type of software. It is also known as the development tools or software development tools, okay? So they are basically used for helping the developers and programmers to write the codes to create applications. That's why it's called programming software. It's used for the programming purpose. And developers and programmers are the one that writes the programming to create the application and develop the application, okay? So those tools typically include an integrated development environment, which stands for which is also known as IDE, stands for integrated development environment. The integrated development environment, it includes the compiler, debugger, and all the other software development utilities, which you will learn it later on when we start our Java programming, okay? And those IDEs, the integrated development tools that you see here, these are just a couple examples of those IDEs. They provide a graphical user interface for writing and editing the source code, so that it can increase the efficiency of the programmers and developers to write the code, maintain the code, and debug the codes. Okay, so those are the programming softwares that we have. And with that being said, we have covered all the different types of softwares, and this module now has been completed. So here are a few key takeaways from this module, Introduction to Computer. So first of all, you need to know what computer is. It's basically an electronic device that is capable of receiving, storing, okay, and processing and outputting the data. That's what computer is for. And this computer, it consists of hardware components as well as the software components, okay? Make sure you do know the hardwares that you are using in your computer and as well as the softwares, including the different types of softwares like programming softwares, application softwares, okay? All of them, and operating system that you have. And the computers, they can perform a wide range of tasks based on the instructions provided by the user. That's the main purpose of the computer, okay? So with that being said, our module 2 now is completed. We are going to start the new module in our next video. Thank you so much. I will see you all in the next video.